evening, everyone. I was supposed to have finished this video a long time ago, but my oldest daughter came and she said she was hungry, so I had to feed her. But even though it's 1 o'clock, I have to finish. I'm committed to finishing my YouTube, and yeah, because I'm on Thursday, basically. So the video for today basically is my truth. I had to learn to accept when I was wrong and to be humble enough, because I'm only in charge of me, and I have to accept when I've been wrong in my life and I have made a mistake, because in life I'm only responsible for my actions, for the things that I do, and when I walk and act incorrect. I don't need to ask and talk about other people, because I'm only responsible for me. And one of the things that I noticed, hopefully you guys can hear me, my thing has been acting up. One of the things that I noticed about me, that basically, it's that I've always thought I was right. My whole life, I've been the kind of person that I think I'm always right. I think that all the things that I say and that I do, I'm correct. And I have, like, control issues. I have codependency issues. And with most of the people that I've been with, I'm the kind of person that even at work, you know, if somebody's not doing it, I'm like, man, move to the side, I'll take care of this. You know, honestly, I have issues badly where I literally have to learn to accept when I myself, I'm fucking up, you know? And I've learned to put my pride down and to accept when I make a mistake. You know, in my past, because of my control issues, the father of my daughter's mom, the father of my daughter's mom used to tell me a generala, which means the general, because I like things right away. Like, when I say something, I like to get it done right away, because it's like, it shows basically value that you're actually acknowledging, you know, the fact that the thing's so wrong. And I notice everything. I've noticed that when people don't like to accept when they're wrong, or when you're telling them somebody to do something, they deflect the question for somebody else, like if it's not concentrated on them. When you're asking somebody something and you're talking about them, it's directed to them, you know? And when you're wrong, you accept that you're wrong for your own self. I literally noticed that because of my codependency relationships and control relationships and domestic violence relationships that I was in, I had stopped talking to my dad. I didn't talk to my dad for 10 years. And my ex literally used to tell me, your dad doesn't love you. He doesn't even give a fuck about you. He doesn't even look for you. And I used to be stupid enough to believe that, you know? And every time I would tell him, let's go see my dad, he was like, why? He doesn't even look for you. But honestly, since I was 15, when my dad brought me from America, he told me, if you don't look for me, I'm not going to look for you. And back then, I didn't understand that, you know? I didn't understand what my dad meant by that. But basically, it just means that you have to know your worth, and you have to know your value, and you also have to know, accept when you're wrong, you know? Because I literally have been put in the position where for 10 years, I didn't talk to my dad because I was embarrassed to come and show to my dad that I had a guy that literally controlled me, who would tell me that my dad didn't love me, and come and show to my dad that I was unhappy. I was embarrassed to come and visit my dad, because my dad knew he hit me. My dad knew he didn't respect me. And I was embarrassed to come and bring my kids, you know, and I was literally controlled by him of what we ate, what we did, where we went. And that's the real fact, you know, that I didn't come and see my family. And I used to feel alone because I didn't see my own worth. I gave him all control and I surrendered everything to him. So when I got separated from him, I literally had to humble myself and come to apologize to my dad and tell him, you know what, Dad? You were right. Everything you said that guy would do, he did. And
I had to learn to
ask for forgiveness because I was embarrassed to say to my dad that he was right, you know? And I literally moved in here because something happened in my family, and I was living in a garage, and my ex
will go and make
me feel bad. He has always intimidated me by telling me his truth, but my truth is that I literally didn't come and see my dad because I didn't want to accept that I was wrong. I didn't want to ask for forgiveness. And until I literally realized that everything that my dad told me that the father of my kids was going to do to me, and that I was wrong, I had to humble myself and be like, okay, Dad, you know what, you're right. You are right. Everything you told me he was going to do, he did.
And
now maybe I understand why I didn't do the video before. Because I wasn't thinking like that before. I have been analyzing where I'm wrong. Which is one of the hardest things as human beings to acknowledge when we are fucked up. And when we have to be humble and be like the prodigal son, you know? And be like, I don't know any better. I don't know that my dad loved me as much as he does. Or I just didn't want to because I always lied to myself. You know? Asking or saying and acknowledging that you're wrong, honestly, it's one of the hardest things I've done my whole life.
I have a lot of
I literally used to cry alone by myself when I was 18. Because
when
I left my house, the father of my kids that I lost it to, he cheated on me. And I literally begged him to come back to me. And I accepted the fact that he had another girl. And that gave me a 12-year lesson, you know, domestic violence. It took a lot of pride for me to come and ask my dad for forgiveness, to accept that I have fucked up, you know? You kind of have to humble yourself and say, you know what, I fucked up. So, be mindful about that.